Hello, honey, to everybody.
Hi.
Hey, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Go to church with me. Today is Youth Sunday. Hey! Gotta make sure my makeup's on fleek. Do they still say that? On fleek? I think I'm okay. Only problem is when I get into worship, I'm falling all off. Jesus saved me. Hallelujah. I love to worship him. We are having breakfast after Sunday school. He done made a whole mess.
Logan.
Logan.
Christmas thought that came to my mind. Rudolph,
the red nose, and the reindeer. And he was different because of why? Because he had a red nose, exactly. He was different, and because he didn't look like all the other reindeer. Because he didn't look like them, they laughed at him, they pointed at him, they called him names. So when I think about that, they didn't let him participate and they shunned him because he was different. The fact that you're unique, it's also went on to say it's not ordinary. Meaning it's not something that you're going to find every day. So when you think about daring to be different, it means that you're not going to be like everybody else. Everybody's not going to look like you. Everybody's not going to sound like you. Everybody's not going to even want to do the things that you do. The things that move me might not be the same things that move you because we are different. People will talk about you because of the color of your hair. They'll talk about you because of the texture of your hair. Whether it's straight, curly, or nappy, they will talk about you. They will talk about the color of your skin, whether you're light or dark or midnight or whatever. People will talk about you. They will clown on you because of the clothes that you wear and the way that you dress. People will judge you because you are different. When I think about Rudolph and when his parents, they realized that he was different. There was something that they wanted to do because they didn't want people looking at him. And they wanted him to fit in. And because they didn't want him to stand out, they wanted to do some things different. And because we don't want people to talk about us, and because we don't want people to be clowning on us because of how we dress, you know, because we don't dress like them. And because, hallelujah, of the things that we do, we don't fit in with them. Oftentimes we find ourselves like Rudolph, and we try to hide, we try to cover up who God has ordained us to be. God has a purpose and a plan for you, and he made you. When God made each and every one of us, he molded us specifically for a designated plan. The scripture says we were predestined. So before we were even formed in the womb, even the scripture says he knew us. Before we were even formed in the womb, before we were even conceived, he already knew us, and he already started molding us the way we were. So if my hair is short and yours is long, God wanted me to have short hair. My voice is really high-pitched, but that's how God made me. I can't change that. I can try to go deep if I want to, but when I get into who I am, it's going to die up. But the things that we're trying to do to try to cover up who we are, because we're trying to be like somebody else. We try to be like Michael Jordan. We try to be like Beyonce. We try to be like Lil Chris or Chris Brown or Lil Kim. We try to emulate people that we see based on what we see them doing. And we look at that and we try to be like them so that we can fit in. But I'm reminded of a singer, Dietrich Hatton, that said, "You can't beat me being me." How many know that Jesus said we are fearfully and wonderfully made? Are unique. So for all of our young people, you are unique. It's not because of what you can't do, for his purpose. There is a distinct difference between being normal and different. When you're different, you don't fit in. I don't care what you do, you don't fit into yourself.